Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Aisha Tadewoyin. Thank you so much for sticking with me. I really appreciate the views I got for my first video. I really appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. So much for liking my videos. I really appreciate. Actually, this will push me to want to come in front of the camera all the time. This will push me to want to put out more value all the time. Thank you so much for staying with me. Today, we are going to talk about how you can picture search on 1688.com. Let's say you don't want to go through all the stress of translating your word to Chinese language. All you have to do is get a picture of your product, a nice picture, a clear picture of your product, and let's dive into the video. Okay, so I'm on my phone now. What I want to do is that I want to go to Google Chrome and download my 1688.com application onto my Android phone. And also, I'll be showing us how you can picture search with your Android phone on 1688.com. So let's search for it. So go to Google Chrome, click on Google Chrome. Launch your Google Chrome app. Once you are on your Google Chrome app, open a new tab here. Then type in 1688.com. Search. Click on search. Once you click on search, it will bring up the home page. Click on this three button at the top right corner of your screen. Once you click on it, click on translate for you to be able to translate your Google Chrome page. Click on it again, then change it to desktop site. So now we're on the desktop site on our phone. Click on the camera button on your screen. Click on it. And it will take us to our. We can select any picture we want to search for. Then now, as you can see it on our stop, the product picture we selected on our phone, it has been scanned and it has been searched for. As you can see, these are the bags we searched for on our phone. So that is how to picture search with your phone on 1688.com. But let's now say maybe you don't want to go through all this stress. There is a way we can do it. We can download the app into our phone, like I said before. Then we have to change our screen back to the normal mobile website. So changes, click on this three button at the top right corner of the screen. Then click on the desktop site so that you deselect it. Okay, then it will take us back to the home page. What we have to do is this line at the top of our screen, we need to click on it so that it will take us to the page where we will be able to download the app. Then come here, click here, once you click there, allow it to load, then click on this orange color button, click on it. Okay, so as you can see, our 1688.com app is not downloading on Google Chrome, and as we've already known, once we translate, we'll be able to download. Anyway, let's continue. The thing we can do now is to download a Firefox web browser. Try to download your Firefox web browser. Then go to launch the Firefox web browser. Once you get your app on your phone, you will not have any problem again. Then type in 1688.com. 1688.com. Click on search.
So like this, it will display it normally the way it's normally displayed. The only thing you cannot do with, as you can see, if you click on the three buttons at the top right corner of your screen, you cannot translate. If you check this web browser very well, you can't translate like Google Chrome. So what we need to do now is to click on this top header again, like I explained before. So click on it. Once you click on it, we want to try to download our app. I've said it over and over again. Click on this button. Allow Firefox to access. Click on allow. As you can see, it says it wants to download so application or so. Click on download. Then now it will start downloading into your phone. You can see it here. If you drop your screen down, it will download into your phone. What we want to do is we want it to download. Then I will be able to explain how you can use iTranslate to translate the app into something that will be easy for you to, so that it will be easy for you to use. So now, as you can see here, our application has been downloaded completely. So we have downloaded it and we have left the web Firefox web browser. Now we want to come to our phone. We want to go to downloads. Click on downloads. Then you'll be able to see your app on it, the APK file. Click on it. Once you click on it, it says staging app. So it says for your security, your phone is not allowed to install unknown apps from this source. Okay. If it says all this, what you need to do is to click on settings. Then once you click on settings, allow the application to install from this source. Click on allow. And to change the color like this, then you have to go back. Click on the exit button on your phone and it will bring you back to the page where it will tell you to install. Then click on install. Once you click on install, it will install itself like this. Then click on open. To continue. Then it will take you back to where you will download. Then you need to click on download again. Click on OK. So it is downloading file again. Open it again. Let it install again. Click on install again. Just follow it through. Whatever it's displaying, just follow it through. So what you want to do now is to open. Click on open. Once you click on open, let me show you how you can use iTranslate to translate all this. Go back, click on this middle button, go back. Then as you have downloaded your iTranslate onto your phone, click on the iTranslate app. Then allow the iTranslate. Click on this button. If you have not changed your language, change the language to Chinese and English. Try to click on it, change the languages to Chinese and English. Click on it. Once you click on it, it will display something like this. Then you have to go back to your app that you've just installed. Then once it's displayed, it will be in one corner of your screen like this. Just click on this thing to become a magnifier. Then move it to whatever word you want to, as you can see on the screen, move it with your finger to whatever word you want to translate to, or you bring it down here. For me now, I wanted to translate this. It says I should agree, or let's say I should disagree. What is this? Disagree. Okay. If you have so many words on your screen, you need to wait for it to translate. But anyway, I don't have that time. So click on this orange button. Click on it. Once you click on it, then voila, your 1688.com app is up and running. Once it's finished loading like this, it will display something like this. What you need to do next is to click on this human icon. Click on it again. Then it will bring you here. Then now you need to enter your login details you created in Alipay. If you don't have your login details with you, then you have to refer to my video on how I explain to you how you can create sign up for 1688.com account on Alipay. Okay, let's do this. Let's type in our name, then I'll type in my password. So I think that's fine. Then click on done. As you can see, we are logged in already. In our next video, we'll be talking about how you can buy products on 1688.com and pay with your Alipay account. If you're having any problem with your whatever you do on your phone while following my video, kindly talk to me in the comment section below. I'll be waiting for you there. Thank you so much. I'll drop the link to where you can sign up on Alipay so that you'll be able to use the account for your 1688.com. I'll drop the link for you at the description box below.